Whether you are a solopreneur crafting your first blog or a seasoned marketer crafting a global strategy, the difference between a good and a game-changing content often comes down to one thing: your toolkit. So in this video, let me show you some of the content marketing tools in our toolkit. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one SEO plugin that empowers millions of WordPress users, and this channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic. So if you're new to us, subscribe. Now, there are a ton of content marketing tools out there, and I'm pretty sure that there are incredible tools that you use, but we don't. So if you don't see your favorite tool in this video, feel free to share it with us in the comments down below. And before we start, we just want to make sure that you know we are not paid or receive any incentives to talk about any of these tools. These are genuine recommendations which we think are useful to you. And without further ado, let's get started. We have categorized our tools into content ideation and keyword research, content creation and optimization, visual and interactive content, content distribution and promotion, and finally, performance tracking and analytics. Let's start with tools that will help you come up with content ideas. Great content starts with two critical questions. What is my audience searching for, and how can I create content that outperforms competitors? Without solid answers, even the best writers end up guessing, and guesswork doesn't rank. So our first tool is this. If you have been following our channel, you know we always talked about this too, because who has more data about keywords than Google, right? So if you want to find keywords related to your blog niche, all you need to do is to click on Discover New Keywords. Let's say that your niche is wedding photography. You can add your seed keyword here. Then if your target audience is worldwide, you want to click on the country and remove any selected country and click Save. From here, you will see that all locations is selected. And if you already have an established website in your niche, you can add your URL here to filter unrelated keywords, but otherwise you will hit get results. And in a while, you will have a list of related keywords together with the search volume, which tells you that there are a lot of people searching for these keywords. If you want a more in-depth video about how to use Google Keyword Planner, feel free to check out this video right here. The link is in the description. Anyway, the next tool in the category is this. Now, whether you are using the free or the pro version of RankMath, as long as you have connected your site with a RankMath account, you will get 750 AI credits every month for free to use the AI tools. One AI credit can generate one word. If you want to find fresh keyword ideas for your niche, you can use RankBot. Simply hover over RankMath SEO and select the Content AI module. Then click on the Chat tab. And from here, you can communicate with RankBot, which is trained to perform SEO tasks. You can say, write a prompt to generate a list of keywords in the wedding photography niche, or whatever niche that you are in. Write the prompt in sentences only. Give it a while, and you will have a good prompt. Let's copy it and start a new chat. Let's paste a prompt here and hit enter or return. And in just a while, you will have a long list of keywords. Now, whenever AI provides you with keywords, you need to verify its search volume, because you don't want to create content on keywords that no one is searching for. It will be a waste of time and resources. So we will copy this list of keywords, head over to Google Keyword Planner, and you want to click on the Get Search Volume and Forecast option. Let's paste the keywords here and remove all the unnecessary words, leaving only the keywords. And now let's hit Get Started. And in a while, you will know what keywords come with search volume and those without. And let's say that we want to do research on this keyword to know what we should write about. We can copy the keyword and head back to the Content AI module. We can select the Topic Research AI tool to get more information about the topic. Let's paste the keyword in the topic field. Select if you want to know more about the recent events, historical events, regional, or whatever. Let's say specific. Then choose how you want the information to be displayed. For me, I will say list. If you have a focus keyword, you can add it here. Otherwise, you can leave it empty. Select your target audience. If you don't find your target audience in this list, you can customize it and hit comma or tab, and a new tag will be created for it. Then select your language and choose the number of outputs and hit generate. In a while, you will get to know more about the keyword you are targeting and what you should include in your content. This will help guide the direction of the research into the topic. Other than RankMath's AI tools for keyword research, you can use this too. I honestly like this tool very much because firstly, it is free, and secondly, it is very easy to use. All you need to do is to visit this page. This is the link. And then you want to add your blog niche here and click Get Started. You would have to create a free account with them. And once you do, you will see a page like this. Click Generate Ideas, and it will provide you with a list of keywords to explore. If you need more keywords, feel free to go back and change your prompt or give a more specific niche or topic. Answer the Public is one of the most recognized tools for keyword ideation. What we recommend you do is to create a free account with them, and you will get 3 searches daily. And then you can search for your niche or related topics here. We will use the same example, wedding photography. Select the country you are targeting, say United States. Unfortunately, they do not have an all locations option. And now let's hit search. And in just a while, you will see keyword suggestions categorized in questions, in people also ask, prepositions, comparisons, and in alphabetical order and etc. You can view the keyword in another format, such as list that looks like this, as well as in tables, which will look like this. And a good thing about this too is that on top of doing keyword research for your blog topic, you can do so for YouTube, TikTok, Amazon, as well as Instagram. It is a really cool tool to use, and if you are a heavy user, you should consider their paid plan. Anyway, other than the tools I've mentioned for keyword research, you should also check out this video right here where I have explored even more tools and we have identified the most accurate one. The link to the video is in the description. When you are ready to create content, here are some tools that will help you out. Don't write your content from scratch. Let the AI do the first draft for you. Now, to use this tool, you will need the Content AI subscription. Similarly, one AI credit can generate one word. And this is the tool right here that can create a comprehensive article for you in a few clicks. Now, there is a 3-step process for this tool. And since we have already done our keyword research, we don't need to proceed with this step. So we can click on skip. The purpose of the next step is to generate a blog post outline for your topic. And let's say that the topic is 10 essential tips for choosing the perfect wedding photographer. The next view is for you to include the main points and ideas that you have researched, probably from the topic research AI tool we have talked about earlier. But if you have not done any research, feel free to click on this Generate with AI, and it will generate some ideas for you. For me personally, when I want the tool to write a comprehensive piece of article, I would leave this field empty and have the AI do the thinking for me. Anyway, you want to add your audience, include your main focus keyword, such as how to choose a wedding photographer, hit comma or tab, and a tag will be created for it. Choose the appropriate tone, assuming your brand voice is friendly, casual, conversational, and knowledgeable. Since knowledgeable is not on this list, we will customize it and hit comma or tab. As for the style, this will determine the direction of the content outline. So please select carefully. I would say that it is a listicle, and then select the language. There are over 28 languages to choose from, but we will keep it as English. And let's hit generate. In just a couple of seconds, you will have a blog post outline. If this is what you are looking for in your content, great. You can move on to the next step. But if not, feel free to click regenerate. But for me, I think this is good enough. It is important that you have the most appropriate outline because the content will be generated based on it. So we will click write post. Give it a while for it to learn the topic, consolidate the knowledge, and write the article. Give it a while for it to do its magic. And in just a few seconds, your first draft of the content is done. And it has generated over 1700 words. Now, what you can do next is to put the content into a new blog post. But instead of clicking copy, create a new post and paste the content, you can click create new post, and the generated content will be included in a new blog post that is well formatted with all the heading tags included. From here, you can optimize your content for SEO using all these SEO checks. First, you want to add your main focus keyword here.
and make sure that you pass all these checks and have the SEO score above 80. That way you know your content is SEO friendly, but it doesn't mean that it is guaranteed to rank though. And if you want to increase the chance of ranking highly for this article, you want to leverage on Content AI's research feature by clicking on the Content AI tab, and you will see the tool here. Add your main focus keyword, select your target location, and hit research. From here, the tool will scrape the information from articles that are ranking at the top for this keyword, analyze them, and provide you with smart suggestions. As you can see, it shows you the recommended content length, the number of internal and external links your page should have, the number of heading tags, the number of images and videos to include, the keywords and related keywords to include in the content, the headings, SEO title, and description, the questions you should answer in your content, and the external links you should include. If you don't see any results here, don't worry. It means that the tool did not find any credible external sources based on the topic that you are targeting. So this tool will only recommend credible external links, and you can be assured that you are not linking to any questionable sites.
With the blog post wizard together with the SEO checks and the Content AI research feature, it will give your content a much higher chance of ranking. By now, you should have heard of Grammarly. It is a tool that will help you check your sentence structure and grammar as you write your content.
As long as you have installed the Grammarly Chrome extension, when you write your content, there will be grammar suggestions for you, so you can easily edit your content for better English as you complete your article.
Using this tool coupled with our content creation and optimization tools, you know your content has the highest chance of ranking. Now, if you have means to take a snapshot, photograph, or create your own original images for your content, great. If not, you can rely on royalty-free sites like Pexels, Unsplash, Pixabay, Lot Icon, and others. But you should never use royalty-free images directly on your site. You need to customize them, hence we recommend this. Photopea is a free alternative to Adobe Photoshop.
From selecting an object or area of a certain color using the magic wand tool, to using the pen tool to create unique shapes, this tool can do most of what you can do on Adobe Photoshop. You can drag and drop images that you have downloaded from royalty-free sites and edit from here. The only downside is that if you don't have any experience with Photoshop, the learning curve for this tool can be steep.
Now, if you want a much easier tool to edit images, you can use Canva.
With Canva, they have a ton of royalty-free templates you can customize with. Just search for templates such as wedding photography, and you will have a lot of templates to choose from. Let's say that you want to customize this template to be used on your site. We can click on it and select Customize this template. And now you can change the text such as Jack's photography. You can adjust the transparency of any object, animate it, flip it, position it, and change the color of the text. And there are many other things that you can do.
There are many Canva tutorials on YouTube, so if you have never used Canva, you can start there. Creating infographics used to be a tedious task, and you may need to spend money hiring a graphic designer if you have no designing skills. But with Piktochart, you can design infographics easily.
You can select if you want to generate infographics, graphics for social media, presentation, or document. For us, we will select infographic. You can choose the style you want. Let's say that we want to create an infographic using this PDF document that includes the statistics of marriages and divorces in Singapore. So I assume we need the chart template. And then what we want to do next is to select the paste text or upload file option. If you are creating infographics with your blog content, you can paste the relevant information here, but we want to upload that PDF. So we will drag and drop it here. Feel free to add additional instructions and hit generate. From here, you can choose a design using any of these templates. Let's say that I like this. Let's scroll through to have a glance. And if you're happy with the design, you can click Save and Edit Chart. From here, you can see that it has generated some graphs based on the PDF data. And you can either customize all this information using the tools here, or export it as an image to upload to your site. Or you can bring these elements to Canva or Photopea for further edits. It's totally up to you. I'm pretty sure you see how useful this tool is.
And with these image editing tools, you can create unique visuals for your site. Once you have created your content, you cannot just leave it to fate to bring in the visitors for you. You've got to do something more to attract eyeballs to your content. Buffer is a social media management tool that allows you to manage several social accounts in one place.
You are able to connect these social media platforms with Buffer. You see, I've connected my LinkedIn, Facebook, and X profile. And now, if you want to create and schedule posts for a particular account, such as this, you just need to click on it and you can create a new post and schedule the date and time for publishing. You can also create posts to be shared on all connected social accounts by going to the All Channels tab. Just click on Create a New Post. If you don't want to share the post on a particular social account, you can just uncheck it. And as you can see, the social account has turned black and white. But otherwise, because every social platform has their unique requirements, you can customize the content for each network. Once you have created the post, it will be scheduled on the next available publishing slots for each social account. As you can see, you can manage the publishing slots by clicking on the settings and adjust the slots accordingly.
Buffer is probably one of the easiest social media management tools to use, so feel free to check them out. If you run a YouTube channel or create long-form content such as a video podcast, this is going to be useful.
Check this out. Most of the shots on our channel are created by Opus Clip. This is the tool and this is the link. You can simply add a YouTube link, give it a while for the tool to fetch the data, and now you can get clips in one click. If you are running a new account, you would have to complete a short survey. Now we have to give it a while. And when it is done, you will get a bunch of short clips based on a YouTube video. And from here, you can download the short video and upload it to your channel.
Now, when it comes to tracking the performance of your content, nothing can be compared to Google Search Console that tracks the search performance of your site and Google Analytics that tracks the overall performance of your site. If you need a complete walkthrough on these two platforms to track the content performance, we have these two videos on our channel. Feel free to check them out. The links are in the description. And if you want to track the performance of a particular keyword to see if your site is ranking well for it,
you can use the RankMath Analytics module. Firstly, to know what keywords a particular page is ranking for, you can click on the SEO Performance tab, scroll down and you will see a list of your content. Let's say that we want to know what keywords this page is ranking for. We can click on it and here is a list of keywords the page is ranking for together with their search performance. And to track the performance of a particular keyword, you can click on the Rank Tracker tab. And from here, you can either automatically track the primary and secondary focus keywords of all your published posts or pages, or you can click on Add to include the keyword you want to track, such as trending blog niche. And as you click Save, the keyword will be added to the tracking list. The number of keywords you can track is based on the plan you have with us. With the Pro plan, you can track up to 500 keywords. Most other tools out there will charge $20 to $50 to track the same number of keywords. If you have the business plan, you can track up to 10,000 keywords and 50,000 keywords for the agency plan.
So these are the content marketing tools we think are useful through personal experiences. If you know of any tools that are useful to you, but I have not mentioned it on this video, feel free to let us know in the comments down below. And if this video helped, do help us out by smashing the thumbs up. Our channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic. And if you haven't subscribed to us yet, consider doing so. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.